Michelle Arnold-Boesiger. A 33-year-old mother named Michelle was living in Harvard, Illinois until late 2020. She was residing in a second floor apartment and suddenly, out of the blue, she said to her downstairs neighbor, "I have to go." But she wouldn't say why. She abruptly moved all of her belongings out of her apartment and was gone. Her family was terrified as to what happened to her. It was a pretty big deal because she wasn't in good health at all. She had a shunt put into her head that went to her stomach, and she had been quite ill for a while. At the time Michelle went missing, she was dating a man named Jonathan Van Doon, who was also 33. The couple had a pretty rocky relationship, in part because Van Doon had a habit of physically abusing his girlfriends. Because she was unable to work, money was tight. The two had been renovating a fifth-wheeler along with a man named Dean Ellis, who was from Wisconsin. The plan was for the three people to live inside of it when they were done. Michelle and her boyfriend had been driving the half-hour trip to Roscoe, Illinois, almost daily, where the trailer was stored. Because of this, it was really odd Michelle suddenly packed up her belongings and disappeared around November of 2020. The trailer itself wasn't inhabitable yet. Her family filed a missing persons report at the beginning of the new year when she still hadn't appeared. On March 1st, 2021, authorities executed a search warrant at U-Haul in Roscoe. It turns out there was a unit that had been rented by Michelle herself. Inside the unit was a black Jeep Renegade, which was registered to her boyfriend. Authorities found Michelle's body inside that Renegade. By then, she was partially mummified. They also found an odor eliminator was placed inside of the vehicle with her. The autopsy labeled the cause of death as homicidal asphyxiation, attributed likely to being drugged, and then possibly strangled while unconscious. Michelle had been covered in blankets and bedding, likely in an attempt to hide the smell from anyone outside. The third man that they knew that was planning on moving in with them, Dean Ellis, was quickly questioned by the police. He said that he last saw Michelle on November 14th, and on that day, she was with her boyfriend. The police were able to tell that on the following day, November 15th, 2020, a passcode was used to enter the storage facility in Roscoe. Whoever entered came in multiple times, beginning at 11:10 a.m. At 2:23 a.m., Michelle was on the phone refilling a pain prescription. From what's been released, it seems that they believe Michelle was the one who filled the pain prescription, but I have a hard time believing that was actually her. The reason I question whether or not it was her, it was only 5 minutes later that her debit card was used to purchase an odor eliminator at the Home Depot. At 2:44 p.m., 10 minutes before the pain medication was refilled, the passcode was again used to enter the storage facility. At 3:47 p.m., which is about 1 hour and 24 minutes after the call for pain pills, Michelle's Dodge Ram could be seen on surveillance cameras driving on the Illinois tollway. However, they could also see inside the Ram, and it was the boyfriend driving, and Michelle's service dog, Atticus, was seated in the passenger seat. Michelle was nowhere to be seen. That same day, Jonathan Van Doon texted Ellis to say that Michelle had overdosed on drugs and was at the hospital. He also told Ellis he would never see her again. However, records show Michelle was never taken to the hospital. 1 week later, someone called the clinic to ask about refilling her pain medication. And this time, the caller identified himself as Michelle's husband. During this time, Michelle's debit card was still being used frequently, but it was clearly not her using it. Someone was doing their best to pretend that they were Michelle. All of a sudden, texts started going out from Michelle asking family and friends for money. At least one of the recipients was clear in the replies that they did not believe it was Michelle texting them. In fact, they said in the text itself that they believed it was her boyfriend and that they suspected he had hurt Michelle. It was then that the text messages abruptly stopped. In that same time period, Van Doon's 10-year-old daughter went missing from her mother's home, where the mother had custody. Police released an Amber Alert, and they believed that the father had abducted her. They said in the Amber Alert, they believed he was taking her to Walworth County, Wisconsin, to a remote property in Indiana. At this time, he was still driving Michelle's vehicle. Van Doon would find himself under arrest on August 6th. His bond would be set at $5 million. Thankfully, his daughter was fine, and he was charged with homicide and concealment of a homicide. The police had been clear that they believed Michelle died on November 15th. At the time of her death, Michelle was still married. She had separated and was in the process of getting a divorce. She had two kids with her husband, Brandon. It's unclear if he had legal custody of the children, but it does appear they were living with him. Brandon described his wife as family-oriented and a great mother who loved her two sons. Brian filed for divorce in November, and at that time, he didn't have his wife's address. This seems to indicate that she hadn't seen her kids lately, perhaps because of her health struggles. It was Michelle's family that reported her missing. It's pretty clear that Michelle had struggled a lot recently. It's not clear if it was an isolated incident, but court documents show that there had been a domestic abuse charge against her husband, Brandon Boesiger, in 2018, alleging that he pushed her into a refrigerator and knocked her around. In 2019, Boesiger pled guilty to a misdemeanor count of disorderly conduct. He was sentenced to 1 year of court supervision and 30 hours of public service. It appears this was what broke the two up. That wasn't the last time Michelle was assaulted by someone she trusted, however. The man she moved in with, Van Doon, assaulted her in July of 2019. He choked her and purposely damaged the lockbox where she kept her pain medication. She had lupus and she was taking oxycodone, and that was inside the box. So there is some indication that her oxycodone pills may have been part of why Van Doon did what he did. Van Doon wasn't even jailed for that incident. He wasn't charged till December of 2019, and by then Michelle was already gone. I know for a fact often what's listed in news articles isn't completely accurate, so it's possible the part I find the strangest isn't even true. It's stated in all documents that it was Michelle who filled that pain medication. I find that really hard to believe because 10 minutes later her card was used to buy the deodorizer. That would mean she planned to OD inside of the car, inside of storage. That makes no sense. I do wonder if it was an accident and he stored her there in order to keep filling her pain meds. I personally find it very strange that she had a lockbox she had to keep her medication in. It seems to me like medication was perhaps a big part of this. This case is currently being prosecuted, and anyone with information is asked to call the McHenry County Sheriff's Office. That's it for today. Thank you everyone so much for watching and listening. Please take a moment to like and subscribe if you haven't already. We have new episodes every Monday and Thursday. Thursdays are always dedicated to John and Jane Doe cases. Take care of yourselves and each other.